It is Marcy Bullock with some stress management tips. Boy, do we need this today, I am telling you. So let's look at what is stressing everybody out. This is some results from our counseling center on campus. When we ask students, what is stressing you out, we can see the variety of factors. If you feel stressed by any of these things, you are not alone. And today we want to give you some tips to help you manage the stress, because we all have stress and some people suffer from it and get physical symptoms, and it gets so bad that it can become life-threatening, and some people manage their stress effectively. I want you to be one of those second group of people. Many of the college students I interact with have an addiction to perfection. The first definition is adaptive perfectionism, setting of high goals and personal standards and striving for the rewards associated with achievement while retaining the ability to be satisfied with one's performance. Now, that is great. You've all gotten to our campus, so you're clearly very accomplished and you push yourself hard. The second type, however, is maladaptive perfectionism. If you hear this definition and connect, we need to help you. Setting of inflexible or unattainably high standards, the inability to take pleasure in one's performance, and uncertainty or anxiety about one's capabilities. Here are some signs and symptoms of excessive academic stress. So a lot of these are symptoms you may personally have experienced. If you are noticing these symptoms, then you have either a mild or extreme level of stress. And this is part of our life. Being a college student, I will tell you, I've worked on 4 different campuses. This is the most stressed out campus I've ever been on. And it's hard being a student at NC State University. There's a lot of pressure. So what can we do? How can we reduce our stress through self-care? All right, you have heard this so many times, and I am going to be a broken record when I say, sweat every day. You get your endorphins going. That is the best antidepressant on the market. And I am quoting my friend Angel Bowers from the Counseling Center when I say that. Putting strong, healthy things into your body makes you feel strong and healthy. Putting crap in your body makes you feel like crap. All right, let's talk about alcohol. Let's talk about caffeine in moderation and avoiding nicotine and other drugs. We have to be aware that this is going to be a depressant to us, the alcohol, and the caffeine can go over the top. So we want to be aware of our consumption. Sleep, 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 sleep. Yes, college students need 8 hours a night. When's the last time you got that? And again, thinking of those symptoms, recognize the signs. If you are feeling sad, anxious, your eating patterns aren't correct, you are abusing substances, these are signs that you need to get some help. And there is help available. I want you to remember that stress is a part of life, but if you work on it, you're going to manage your stress so much better. So let's think about organizing and prioritizing. Let's plan breaks. And when we set up breaks in our studies, let's see them as a reward for our productivity. Let's reward ourselves. Maybe get up early in the morning so we can plan out our day and feel more alive and on top of things. Avoid taking on too much. We have to learn to set boundaries and say no. Have some balance in our schedule based on what's important to us, and try to delegate things as much as possible. Sometimes stress becomes overwhelming, and it can, like I said, be life-threatening. So we want to take advantage of our counseling center. Here is the phone number. Here is the website. 100% utilize these resources. So a study found that people who were able to manage their stress had 4 things in their life. One was the exercise I talked about. One was a friend or support person they could turn to. One was time for themselves, and one was a belief in something bigger than themselves. So if you have those four things, it's going to help you manage your stress. But the trends we're finding in college mental health are that thousands of students are needing assistance and support to get through. 32% report being so depressed in the last year it was difficult to function. Over half of students report overwhelming anxiety. This just hurts my heart. These statistics go on and on. So over twice as many students reported significant negative academic impact from emotional stress than medical concerns. Please reach out to the counseling center. Please know that we are here to help you. And 100% realize that we can help you manage your stress and you can get through this. We're here for you.